John Tavares, classy as ever, says, nobody has walked in my shoes. Nobody knows what went into my decision to go back and sign with the Toronto Maple Leafs. What did you make of his comments?
I think he's right. He's the only one that's John Tavares. I mean, how many John Tavares are there on the planet of 7.2 billion people that are impersonating him? No one. So, you know, I had a chance to speak to his agents throughout that free agency process several times, 2 to 3 times a day, both Pat Brisson and Jim Nice. What's happening, guys? What do you have? What's the word? What's he going to do? We see we don't know. We see we're not sure. And he ended up entertaining some of the real offers and overtures from some of the teams. He wanted to meet with different teams. And in some of those meetings, he was wowed. And this was a tough decision because Long Island is home. It's where he called home. He was the face of the franchise during a very difficult period and was there for 9 years, as you both alluded to earlier. And then he ended up having the opportunity, a unique one by way of free agency, to go home, to his actual home, where his parents are, where his family is, where he spends his offseason, by way of the free agency process. So one thing that, you know, we love the passion of our fans. We really love and appreciate that. But sometimes you have to remember, just because somebody makes a personal choice to make a decision and a professional choice to make a decision, it doesn't necessarily give you the right to eviscerate them and to discredit who they are as people. And that's the part for me that I think it went a little bit far with some people. John Tavares has always been classy. He always will be classy.
Yep.
He's not
yep.
unclassy because he's right. not playing for the team that you would prefer him to play for. I think that becomes a little bit pompous, a little arrogant there.
Yeah, and you're not going to get John Tavares to say anything bad. He's not going to do it. Not very few players are. He had a fantastic run with the New York Islanders. He was, you said, the face of the franchise. What I like to see now is the Islanders are turning the page. Maybe this is turning the page for the fans. This is a different team. This isn't John Tavares' team anymore. This is a different team, and it's a winning team. It's different management, different coach, different mindset. And that is what the New York Islanders needed. Maybe they needed John Tavares to leave. Maybe they needed to say, we need to play a different brand of hockey. We need to find a different way to win hockey games. They're doing it. Good for them. Always nice when you can bring your ex-star back and beat them like that at home. There's no question. That's fun for the fans. The players, they could probably care less. Hey, we scored 6. They're more than happy that they beat one of the top teams in the National Hockey League and beat them soundly at home. In the last game they played, they beat them 4-0. So if these two teams are going to play in the playoffs, which eventually it might happen, right now, the New York Islanders have got the upper hand in the game. So I like what I'm seeing with the New York Islanders. I haven't bought into them all year. I'm still waiting. It's always, are they waiting for the shoe to drop? But I don't see it dropping. This is a very resilient team. They've got depth in scoring. Goaltending's playing really well. And they're going to be a tough team to handle come playoff time.
And before we get to playoff time, they're going to meet one more time, these two teams, at Nassau Coliseum on April Fool's Day. We'll see if the Boo Birds are a little quieter or if it's just as fiery as it was tonight.